Hello student, Hemant sir is here. So today we are going to start the first question of exercise, or we can say practice set 1.3. Okay. So in previous video we have already seen about the postulates of Euclid and their examples. Okay. So today we are going to understand the first question of practice set 1.3. The first question says, write the following statement in if then form. That we already discussed in our previous video that we have to convert our statement into if and then form, that is in conditional statement form. हमको जो question दिया हुआ है इसको conditional statement के form में represent करना है. Okay, that means we have to use if then. Okay, so the first sub question says, the opposite angles of parallelogram are congruent. Here we have to use if and then. See, we know parallelogram. What is parallelogram? The opposite side of parallelogram are parallel to each other. That is, these are the parallel line. Okay. And this is our parallelogram. So, the question says the opposite angles, that means this angle and this angle are congruent, and this angle are congruent. Okay. If these opposite angles of the parallelogram are congruent, that means suppose parallelogram it is A, B, C and D. So we have to write A is congruent to C and B is congruent to D, then it is a parallelogram. Okay, so we have to convert this statement in if then form. So how? If the opposite side or opposite angles of parallelogram are congruent, then the given quadrilateral is parallelogram. So we have to write the statement. So statement, the answer will be, if opposite side, opposite angles of quadrilateral, opposite angles of quadrilateral quadrilateral are congruent, then it is parallelogram. See, here the conditional statement we have. If opposite angles of quadrilaterals are congruent, then it is a parallelogram. So we have already used here if and then. Okay. So this is the given statement and we have converted this statement into form of conditional statement. Okay. Now we have next example. The diagonals of rectangles are congruent. Okay. So we can say if, it is answer. Okay. If diagonals of, if diagonals of quadrilateral are congruent, then it is rectangle. Okay, this is the way we have to convert the given statement into conditional statement, that is in if then form. Okay, so now we will see the next question. Before going to start next question, you have to write both the questions. So write down now. So now we will solve the next problem. It says, in an isosceles triangle, you know what is isosceles triangle? The triangle which have all sides equal. Okay. The segment joining the vertex and it is vertex and the midpoint of the base is perpendicular to the base. Okay, so we have to convert this statement into if then form, that is in conditional statement form. So we have to write if the triangle is isosceles, if the triangle is isosceles, is isosceles, then the segment joining the vertexes, the vertex joining the vertex and the midpoint of the base is perpendicular to the base. Okay, so this is the conditional statement form, which is in if and then form. Okay, so now this is the solution of first question. We had three sub questions where we had to convert the given statement into conditional form. Now we are going to solve the second question. Okay, so write down this question first. So now we are going to solve the second problem. The second problem have three sub questions. So first question says, in second question we had to write the converse of the questions. Converse means जहां पर हमारा if के बाद वाला जो sentence है and then के बाद वाला sentence है उनको interchange करना है. Okay? So antecedent किसको कहते हैं? Those statements they are comes after if. उसको हमको क्या करना है? Interchange करना है उस sentence से जो consequence करते हैं जिसे हम जो then के बाद में आएगा. Okay? So first question we have the alternate angle formed by two parallel lines and their transversal are congruent. So this is the given statement. Now we have to write the converse of this statement. So converse of statement will be, if the alternate angles made by two lines and its transversal are congruent, then the lines are parallel. So what we have done? We have converted our antecedent into the antecedent, which is the statement comes after if, and of the statement which comes after then are called as consequences. So antecedent ko humne consequence bhi kya kar diya, interchange kar diya. Okay, so this is the statement which is converse of the given statement. Okay, now second one we have, if a pair of an interior angle made by a transversal of two lines are supplementary. Supplementary means the sum of angle which is equals to 180 degree are called as supplementary. Okay, then the lines are parallel. So lines kya hogi? Parallel hogi. So it is a given statement. So what we have to do? We have to convert this given statement into its converse form. Okay, so what we have to do again? The same thing that we have done in the previous sentence. Okay, that means antecedent ko consequence mein aur consequence ko antecedent mein convert karna hai. Okay, so the statement will be, if two parallel lines, this is it, yahan pa parallel hai, to parallel ab aa gaya in front mein. Okay, if two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal line, the interior angles are found are supplementary. Supplementary means again the sum of two angles is equals to 180 degree. Such angles are called as supplementary. Okay, so this is the given statement and it is its converse form. Okay, so now we have one more statement that we have to convert in inverse form and our exercise will be done. That is our practice it. Okay, so first write down these two examples, then we are going to solve the last example of this exercise. Okay, so write down. So now the last question that we are going to solve of our practice set 1.3. Okay, here again we have to convert the given statement into its converse form. Okay, so the statement is the diagonals of rectangles are congruent. So it is the given statement. So we have to write its converse. So converse kya ho jayega? The diagonals of Okay, so if the diagonals of quadrilateral, अब यहाँ पर आप rectangle है नहीं बताएंगे, हम क्या बताएंगे यहाँ पर, it is a quadrilateral are congruent, then it is a rectangle that we have to show. Okay, so क्या हो जाएगा, if the diagonals of quadrilateral are congruent, then it is a rectangle. Okay, so this is the way we have to convert our statement into its converse form. Okay, so write down. So student, here we have completed our exercise, that is the practice set 1.3, and it is the end of our chapter. So we have few questions which are given in problem set. आपको मैंने इस chapter में homework बहुत कम दिया हुआ है, okay? So आपको क्या करना है? Problem set की जो question है, they are depends on practice set 1.1, 1.2 and 1.3. So you have to solve all the problems. Then अगर आपसे नहीं बन रहे, then we will solve those problem which are not solved by you. Okay, so आज के लिए इतना ही, मिलते हैं next video में. And one more thing, that if you are getting any problem in question solving, then call me between 4 to 6 p.m. in the evening. Okay, so bye for now.